Today I'll be teaching a ARDL bound test to find out whether there is any long run relationship between the variables. In the previous video I taught you as to how to find out the short run relationship. So the file is on the screen. Move on to view. Scroll down to coefficient diagnostics. It is a continuation of the previous video. Scroll down to bounds test to find out whether there is a long run relationship. So see the F statistics, the value 17.968, which is above the upper and lower bound test. The critical value of the upper bound is 6.36 at 1% significant level. This means that the null hypothesis of no co-integrating relationship can be rejected, which implies that GDP is co-integrated with employment and CPA. So there exists a long-run relationship between the variables. Suppose the F statistic value lies between IO bond and I1 bond, then it is better to do ARDL. Or if the F statistics is below IO bond, it is better to do again ARDL model alone and not the bound test. Now we will move on to view to find out the co-integration. Scroll down to coefficient diagnostics. From there, move on to co-integration and long run form. Click over it. So you can find the co-integration equation where you find the coefficient is negative as well as significant, indicating that there is a long run relationship. The coefficient is negative, it implies that the speed of adjustment towards long run equilibrium is 154%, or system corrects its previous period disequilibrium at a speed of 154% within one period of time. The T statistics is minus 7.220443 and the coefficient is significant. In the case of employment and CPA, both has got as positive and I'll just scroll it down. Both has got a positive and significant impact on GDP in the long run. Now the next one is to test the residuals. So move on to view, move on to residual diagnostics. In that, move on to histogram normality test. So you find that the residuals are normal. The p value is greater than 0.05. Then next you have to find out whether there is any serial correlation. Move on to residual diagnostic. The serial correlation LM test. Let the lag be as default. There again you can see the observed R square and the corresponding p value again proves that it is free from serial correlation. Then again move on to view, move on to heteroscedasticity test, and let Bruch, Pagan, Godfrey test be as such and click OK. There again you have got your observed R square and the respective p value. So this also proves that it is free from heteroscedasticity. So next we are moving to stability diagnosis. So first we are going to view, going to stability diagnostics, and we are going to Ramsey reset test. Let the number of fitted terms be as default as 1. Click OK. So you see your F statistics. It is 0.5342 the p value, which suggests that the model is well specified. Now to do KUSUM test as well as KUSUM of squares, For that, you have to go to View, Representation, click Representation, select the estimation equation, copy it, and later go to Quick, go to Estimate Equation, paste it over here, let least square be as such, click OK, you delete the equation, this will be same as that of ARDL, this answer, the coefficient error T and P will be same with that of ARDL. Go to View, go to Stability Diagnostics, there you have got Recursive Estimates, where you have got Kusum Test, click OK. So you can see it remains, the Kusum plots remains between the 5% critical bonds, that is the blue line should be within the red line, which proves the stability of the parameters. So you can say the model is structurally stable. For the next one, for the squared one, again move on to Stability Diagnostics, from there move on to Recursive Estimates, select Kusum of Squares Test and click OK. That too lies within the 5% critical bond, which again proves the stability of the parameters. So the model is structurally stable. But if Kusum and Kusum squares exceed the 5% critical point, then we can confirm that there is an instability of the coefficient. This is how you have to interpret your results in your project, dissertation, and thesis. Thank you for listening.